All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Ilan Sobel. He is the CEO of BioHarvest Sciences. And Ilan, welcome back. Good to see you again. I know you're on the road, are you?
Firstly, Steve, it's great to see you. Yes, I am in the US of A. I've been here now for a week. I'm actually in Miami at the moment. It's been a crazy week in starting in LA, then in Seattle for to complete some of the work on our coffee launch. Then I was in Atlanta for a couple of days working on our hydration strategy. Had two amazing days there on finalizing some of the product development work. And then I was in Nashville on Friday on where we filmed the Huckabee show. We had a great show on Saturday night. Also aired again last night where we talked a lot about Vinia, as well as gave Huckabee viewers and TBN viewers a first opportunity to purchase our Vinia Superfood coffee, which is going to be shipping out in the middle of this month. And now I'm here in Miami, about to get on a plane back to Israel in a few hours' time.
Yeah, so it's good that you're talking about Vinia and in the United States as well, because that was really a driver for your Q3 numbers that you put out, where you saw 113% year-over-year increase in revenue, and that is basically off of the strong sales of Vinia, especially in the United States.
Correct, Steve. You know, we have just consistently delivered quarter on quarter the growth that I think our shareholders are expecting. Q3, we saw, as you said, 113% growth, $3.24 million. Importantly as well is the quality of the growth. Our gross profit increased from 18% in Q3 last year to 45% this year. And we have a very clear building block on how we move that gross profit north of 50%, then north of 55%, then north of 60% over the next 12 to 18 months. We've also given, you know, a big jump in the Q4 guidance, obviously based on what we've seen so far in the quarter. And that guidance we gave of $4.2 to $4.5 million for the fourth quarter. And we feel really good about that.
Yeah, your margins also improved as well. And that's an exciting part of this as well, because obviously the better the margin is, the better things will come into the company.
Of course. I mean, there's a relentless focus on driving profitability in the company. And that's obviously at a gross profit level. As I said, we increased the GP from 18% to 45%. And then importantly as well, as it relates to marketing effectiveness, our cost of acquisition of our customers declined by 22%. So not only are we improving gross profit, but we're also reducing the cost of acquiring new customers into the franchise, which is growing dramatically right now. And ultimately, over time, that's going to get us to that break-even position and get to a cash flow positive position for the company. Super important for us. And that's what myself and the management team are maniacally focused on.
Yeah, just two quick questions for you, Ilan. One is Amazon revenue in Q3 up 84%. So that's that Amazon, it's amazing how they continue to be a big driver for products, including yours.
Yeah, I think, again, what's important is the understanding the underlying, you know, fabric of that kind of growth, because we've seen this tremendous growth in Amazon without us actually growing our investment in Amazon. So what you're seeing is it's organic growth. It's basically consumers coming in. It's the recommendations we get from the Amazon algorithms. It's positive reviews. All of this is organic. It's families having one person, Steve. One person starts on Vinia, and then we get the partner, and then we get the mother, and then we get even the mother-in-law we get. You know, and that's kind of organic growth that we're getting. We see it on our subscription business, which again is super healthy. Our subscription base increased also significantly, 213% growth in subscription base versus last year. And we see that same quality of organic growth in Amazon. And we expect that to continue as we move into the fourth quarter as well.
Okay. And lastly, Ilan, you did mention the coffee, and I just want to reiterate that again, that'll be available to consumers fairly soon.
Yeah, we're going to open it up to basically broader consumers. We're looking to get onto Amazon before the end of the year. And then obviously in January, it's full force ahead around the superfood coffee. We'll be talking more about that in the next couple of weeks as we start to kind of scale that launch. But yeah, super exciting. We've got a very differentiated functional coffee proposition that's coming into the marketplace in both decaf as well as regular, and a lot more to come in that area. We saw some very encouraging results coming out of Huckabee show on Saturday night, where TBN consumers of Huckabee had the opportunity to actually come in and purchase the coffee. And we'll start to ship that coffee starting December 14. We'll start to ship that coffee to customers. So they'll be enjoying that coffee for Christmas. And we're looking forward to seeing all the great reviews that we expect to come, because it's a great tasting coffee, Steve. We've done so much taste testing on this, quantitative blind taste testing, and then you've got all the benefits of Vinia. So looking forward to that being a big incremental jump on our business, on top of the great momentum we have on what I call our core business, which is the capsule business.
Yeah. Ilan, safe flight back to Israel. My friend, good to talk to you again, and we'll talk soon, okay?
Thanks. I got to run to the airport right now to make sure I get that flight. Thank you, Steve. Take care.
All right. Well, just enough time for us to say Ilan Sobel, the CEO of BioHarvest Sciences.